Hi guys, I'm back. Okay, so I'm going to be reviewing another story by Peter Chimaera. Which, by the way, you know his stories are horrible if you've seen my last two videos and the ones that follow. So, this one is called Quarterlife, Halfway to Destruction. Oh, and what's funny about this is that this is a Half-Life fanfiction. Yeah, so it's by Peter Chimaera. It's one of his 12 stories. It's rated T, it's in English, it's an adventure, and has 166 reviews. All of which, I'm sure, say it's horrible. Alright, so, let's begin. Quarterlife, Halfway to Destruction. A foo whore's nose. Who's a foo whore, and why is his nose talking to us? Would you like my nose to do a review? Do you want to see my nose up against the camera while it's reading a fanfiction? I didn't think so. Actually, that'd be pretty funny. Uncylopedia, that's a nice way to pronounce it, Uncylopedia, which is online encyclopedia, pedia, that's what it says, like Wikiped. What is that, a website for mopeds? Said I was writing story. What? So you're just now, so this website randomly came to you and said, you're going to write a story like this. Called Quarterlife, Halfway to Destruction, and I don't know where come, but I decide to write anyway. What? Man, this guy is just, like, stupid. Let's see. Chapter 1, what it means. Gordon Freechman was studying in his, laboratoried. Fellow student Cow Orker? What's a cow orker? Oh, excuse me now. I have to go ork my cows. Jim said, Gordon Fremant, what are you working on? I have discovered new radioactive isotope, but it is so volatile. I think that's what he meant to say. Volatile? I don't know. That it does not have a half-life, but quarter-life, so we must observe with hasty. Juts, then a head crab went on Jim's head. Oh no, where did head crab come from? Head crab. Gordon went to get his crowbar, but it was missing, so he had to borrow Claymore's sword. He hits head crab, and Jim was okay, but his head was cut. Now, honestly, if you hit someone in the head with a sword, and it cuts their head, I doubt they're going to be okay. Watch where you swings at me. Just kidding, thanks. Ha ha, they laughed. What eight? Oh no, where id isotop? You it has been stolen. Chapter 2. They revo, sir. Isotrope, but they don't. So they get it, but they don't. They recover it, but they don't. I don't know. Gordon and Jim arrived at Te Alien Scene, where a bad guy from the game said, I will take the... Where a bad guy from the game? Oh, no. No, no, no. No, you don't do that. You don't do that. It may be a game, but if you're writing a story about it, you have to write it as if it's in the actual game. You can't say, a bad guy from the game. That is just not right. Said, I have to take the isotope and it will cause meltdown. No, not all of Dallas, which was target of where they were, and it was a nice place and my friend lives there. Oh my god. I swear this guy's embarrassing to authors. I don't know what his issue is. Let me see. It was a nice place and my friend lives there. You don't put that in a story, okay? If you do not agree to my demands, too late, and the isotope hit Quarterlife and that room was slowly become vaporized. Ew, must escape out of here fastly, but Jim was already blown to smithereens. Smithereens! Smithereens! Speak smithereens! Let's blow ourselves to smithereens! Destruction is imminent. This is Gordon Freeman. How do we contain Te Meltdown? I know. And he used portals to push enemy headquarters in to a portal so Dallas wouldn't melt down, and it would only go off harmless in the Atlantic Ocean. Hooray, I succeeded at winning the mission. Not so fast, Mr. Gordon. What happens next, you decide. Thanks for reading. Please buy my book at peterchimera.com. I am poor. Who is going to buy your book? Your story sucks. Who would buy your book? God. And I hope you are poor. See what this does? Horrible stories bring out my evil. Who would buy your book? Who would even go to that website? It's probably a virus. Alright. Well, I think I have enough time to fit in one more story. Desert Bus Ride 1. Oh yeah, this is the only one I know of his that actually reaches 700 words. Big surprise. I think I might be able to fit it in. Yeah, it's only 700 words. I can handle it. Desert Bus Ride number 1. Desert Bus Ride 1, a romance story and for ladies. It's a game X over fanfic by Peter Chimaera, one of 12 stories rated K+, English, romance, reviews 55. Let's start. Mr. Oakland, was he driving? He was drive to get the place was Las Vegas, but had made to drive all the way for 8 hours approximately. Oh great, he am talk loudly at him. It was too long for enjoyable ride. Just suddenly there was time to drive faster. Oh no, speed limit, he announced or read to his driving bus, who was shocked. They wondered what was his drive problem. Wow. I can't believe that. It's just horrifying. It makes me sick. Passengers became listened to him as he told them what happened. It is a powerful drive across the desert. No man, they said them quietly. Excuse me for a minute. Forgot to copy the link. There we go. Alright. One man is powerful warlock, and he discovered this desert incredibly. Scares children, one mother said, and she was scared with earmuffs. Scared with earmuffs. It is not cold in desert, so Mr. Oakland did not know why she wear them, so he leaves bus operation to investigate. A man who was there drove as well because he could drive a bus with his license. The earmuffs were made of scientific discovery. I didn't know you could make stuff with scientific discovery. Oh my gosh, that gives so many new ideas. It keep me cool while we drive bus, she explained. Mr. Oakland decided to believe her story, but knew there was something up. We nearly hit a skunk, said the driver man, who was named Bob Orlando, and he speaked with no nervousness, for the task was unfrightening. We did not hit, so it okay. I must drive for safety, Mr. Oakland say, and he get back into wheel. Bob Orlando fall. He's sick. No, Bob replied. Thank you for your concern, kind woman. I have lost it, my balancing. When he gets up, they find blood. How far to Las Vegas, and if they have hospital? The lady woman. The lady woman. Oh my gosh. A lady woman. I always thought there were just man women and, you know, lady men. I didn't know there was a lady woman. Or a woman lady or whatever. My gosh. Let's see. Said with her dress in her fist. So she's naked? It is 7 hours and 45 minutes, so hold on for speed, but we must make most of gasoline. So they did not speed up. I am okay. Bob putted his hand on the blood and it stopped, so it was only small blood. What is name? Margaret, she say distantly as look out window into desert. It was hot, so she holding dress carefully in case of hot exhausting. What is hot exhausting? Ah! I see you are wearing an expensive dress. I thought she was naked because she's holding the dress in her fist. Thank you. It is one of my favorite clothing, but it is not important. I have meet my boyfriend in Las Vegas, and he will be in trouble. Bob was sad that she had girlfriend. So she's naked on a bus, and she's a lesbian. Well, this story is certainly interesting. But knew he would win her triumphantly to like him and maybe get a very good cup of coffee. But why, he asked of information. My boyfriend is worked for FBI and they have dangerous terrorism. That is outrageous, Bob demanded. I hope he is safe. Thank you for concerning you, Mr. Oakland thought carefully. It was too hard to tell the truth that his first name was Kyle Roberts. His whole first name is Kyle Roberts? Wow. Hey, Kyle Roberts, how's it going? And he worked for FBI too, but internal affairs send him to watch FBI. Internal affairs? Look, so there's like a mission going on in your stomach? How about in your gallbladder? Maybe your kidneys or your spleen? Affairs send him to watch FBI, so he did that Margaret boyfriend would be him job. Stressed, he almost drove off the line, but he pressed less and did not. It was a close one, he said, but no one understand and did not know, so he did not bother with them. One man on the bus was from India, and he talked of what it like to grow up in India. When they arrived, boyfriend was got shot. He am hit by bullets, Margaret thought loudly. This is all because terrorists. Mr. Oakland punched fist into air with angry. He was angry. Boyfriend said, I am Jim and I am your cousin, Kyle. If someone got shot, would they really just take time to introduce themselves? That's stupid. It was too much for Mr. Oakland. Cried in bus for 8 hour drive back to Tucson, Arizona. He never found out how it went at hospital and was never told. What happened? Asked an old woman. This is frightening me. We will be back very soon, but it will be very dark, he said to new passengers. One of the passengers worked with Kyle Roberts for FBI many years ago, but Mr. Oakland could not tell him the harsh news. Kill me! The end. Dedicated to brave FBI. At least he had a cause to write a horrible story. He didn't just write it. Oh my God, have mercy! Oh. Well, isn't this just lovely? My head is now dizzy from having to read this horrible story. Alright, so I'm going to post the link to the last two stories right there in the description down there. So, yes, you can view them and review them and all that, etc. crap I have to say every single time I do a video. Oh, my throat hurts now. Alright, so I'm going to go get a glass of water and be back in a few minutes to finish the review of the rest of his horrible, horrifying stories. So, I hope you enjoy. Later.